It is a chance for me to be invited by His Excellency Prime Minister to visit this wonderful place. The landscape is wonderful. Nature is preserved. I think it is very important. And I want to ask local authorities, population, to preserve this. It is a treasure. Admiring this kind of landscape is unusual. And I think it is a wealth to be preserved. And I think with the launch of this resort, tourism will grow in this region. But it is an ecotourism. So it is very important to preserve this wealth and at the same time, giving the opportunity for the local population to grow, to see prosperity and development. So sincerely, it is a very, very wonderful project. And I encourage Prime Minister, the government, and the population of this region to keep going, to preserve this nature, and at the same time, to give the chance for others to visit this very, very wonderful nature. You know, ecotourism is a great opportunity for Africa. At the level of the African Union, we're trying to promote tourism in our continent. But it should preserve at the same time the ecosystem. So ecotourism is very important. Sincerely, before coming here, I didn't imagine that in Ethiopia there is this kind of landscape. But discovering this part of Ethiopia is very amazing. So I think it is, I'm very surprised and at the same time very pleased. In general, tourism in some countries destroys the nature. And I think promoting this new kind of tourism, of ecotourism, and involving local populations is a very, very good choice. So we have to encourage it. And it is a good example to be followed by other African countries.
ወንጪ ዳጋታሎኝ ወንጪ እንግዲህ በአገራችን ካሉ በጣም ውብ የሆኑ የተፈጥሮ ጸጋ ከታደላቸው ቦታዎች አንዱ ነው። ተፈጥሮ ያደለው ውብ አካባቢ ነው። እንግዲህ የተፈጥሮን ውበት ሰው ደግሞ አይቶ የተሻለ ውብ እንዲሆን ከማድረግ አንፃር ወንጪን ድሮም ማቃትና አሁን ማቃት ወንጪ የበለጠ አምራ በሰው እጅ ተነካክታ ውብ ሆና ውበት ብቻ ሳይሆን አንደኛ ከሁሉም በላይ ለአካባቢ ህብረተሰብ የገቢ ምንጭ ይሄ ውበት ይሄ የሚያምር ተፈጥሮ የገቢ ምንጭ የሚሆንበት የአካባቢ ህብረተሰብ ህይወት የሚቀየርበት ከሁሉ በላይ ከዛም አልፎ የኦሮሚያም ከዛ በላይ የኢትዮጵያንም የቱሪዝም እንቅስቃሴ የበለጠ ወደ ተሻለ ደረጃ አድርሶ ሌሎች ከኢትዮጵያ ብቻ ሳይሆን ከውጭ ሀገር የሚመጡ ቱሪስቶችን የሚያስተናግዱበት ሁኔታ የሚስብ ነው የሚመስለኝ። ቱሪዝም እንግዲህ የተፈጥሮ ቱሪዝም አንደኛ ኢንቨስትመንት ይጠይቃል። መንግስት አሁን በራሱ ነው ኢኒሼቲቭ ወስዶ ይሄንን እየሰራ ያለው። መንግስት በመንግስት ብቻ የሚሰራ ነገር መንግስት መጀመሪያ መነሻውን ነው የሚያሳየው። ከሁሉ በላይ ፕራይቬት ሴክተሩ ነው እዚህ ላይ መስራት ያለበት፣ ፕራይቬት ሴክተሩ ነው መሳተፍ ያለበት። ስለዚህ የፕራይቬት ሴክተሩ አሁን የተሰራውን መንገድ፣ መብራት፣ የተሰሩት እነዚህ ነገሮች ተበረታቶ ወደዚህ ሴክተር ከገባ ዋናው ባለቤት እንግዲህ የፕራይቬት ሴክተሩ ነው የሚሆነው። ፕራይቬት ሴክተሩ የበለጠ መንግስት አሁን ያዘጋጀውን ያመቻቸውን ሁኔታ ወደ ተሻለ ሁኔታ ያደርሰዋል ብዬ ነው የማምነው። እንግዲህ አፍሪካ በቱሪዝም ሀብት በጣም የታደለች ነች። በሁለት ነው የሚከፈለው። አንደኛው የተፈጥሮ ቱሪዝም ነው፣ ሁለተኛው ታሪካዊ ቱሪዝም ነው። በታሪካዊ ቱሪዝም ኢትዮጵያ እንግዲህ በሰሜን አካባቢ ያሉ የኢትዮጵያ አካባቢዎች በጣም የታወቁ ናቸው። በመሀከለኛውና በደቡብ ኢትዮጵያም ያሉ አንዳንድ ቦታዎች በጣም ታዋቂ ናቸው። የኢትዮጵያ የተፈጥሮ ቱሪዝም በደንብ ያው ቀደም እንዳልሽው በደንብ የታየ አይደለም። በጣም የሚያማምሩ ወንጪን ጀምሮ ሶፉ መርን ካየሽ ሌሎች አካባቢዎች ባሌ የባሌ ተራራዎችን እና ወደ ምራብን በተጂ በጣም ብዙ ነገሮችን በከተፈጥሮ ጋር ተያዙ ነገሮችን ማየት ትቻለሽ። ይሄንን ወደ ተሻለ ቦታ ለማድረስ ኢንቨስትመንት ይጠይቃል።
And I've been to many places around the world. I've seen many beautiful natural spots. This one is one of the most beautiful I've ever seen. And so I feel very privileged and very honored to visit this new spot to me here in Ethiopia. Jobs, opportunities, building infrastructure, tourism can contribute to so much of this and bring additional value to those who have been living in this splendor for so many years. Honey, tourism, hiking, so many opportunities are provided by small bits of infrastructure that we are seeing here today. Africa can learn so much from what we're seeing here in terms of realizing tourist potential. From what I understand, these public investments are small steps forward to encourage the private sector, both here in Ethiopia and internationally, to come and follow this example. And if what I've seen here today is any small example, I know it will happen. I know it will happen.
First of all, it's my pleasure to be here, and I have to thank Dr. Abiy Ahmed to invite me here, because it's a wonderful place. This is an incredible potential for tourism, and you know, from the natural point of view, it's a benchmark for all Ethiopia. I mean, Wancha area is amazing, and the two lakes are really a nice spot where to spend, you know, days or holidays and to meet the nature. So it's something that belongs to the green legacy as well. I mean, people here could enjoy nature, I could even see the real part of Ethiopia. That is amazing. It's really amazing. I think I see an impact because this lodge could have a pivotal role for even for other parts of Ethiopia, in the meaning that you know, once you start here, it could be just like a drive for other projects like this, eco-friendly. And, you know, you should keep to have this space because, I mean, I think to respect nature is one of the most important things, and at the same time to joy with nature. And, you know, I hope that you will have other projects like this that could, afford people to meet nature on this way. This is a good example of integration with community. It's the only way to be sustainable because, I mean, community is a part of the project, and that is a very clever idea because they could earn from the project, they are, you know, even could benefit from the project. At the same time, they could live in a different way, maybe better than it was before. So it's a win-win situation for the government and for the community.
Well, first of all, a huge thank you to His Excellency the Prime Minister for being so generous with his time and showing us this wonderful project. I've been really impressed by the vision which has been turned into an incredible reality here. We have a top-class resort with fantastic facilities based in this amazing location. The countryside really is amongst the best that I've seen. And actually, with it being so green and some streams and a little bit of cloud cover, I feel quite at home. It's a little bit like being back in some of the best parts of England. So a really fantastic project here that's been delivered. Well, I think it will really help show that Ethiopia can compete with some of the world's top tourist destinations. And I've been really impressed to see the way in which this project is integrated with the local community. So visitors can come here and spend time living with members of the local community. And like some projects, sometimes local communities are displaced. That's absolutely not the case here. It seems to be really working in harmony with the local communities, and I think international tourists will find that very attractive and appealing. I've been really impressed by the design, which seems to be very sympathetic with the natural environment. It blends in really well, and you feel like you're living right in the nature here. You're spending your time in a very calming, peaceful place with the bubbling streams and the natural springs and the mineral water. It really is a very special location. I think the development is very sympathetically done, so I'm very impressed.